والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى خصوصا على أفضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الأمين محمد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. Brother Chairman, brothers and sisters in Surah Al-Athar, we praise and thank Allah for the opportunity to be with you here tonight, and we pray that our session here tonight may be blessed by Him and that it may be of benefit to all, inshallah. Dajjal's deadliest weapon. Who is Dajjal? And why does he have weapons? Who gave him the weapons? And what is he using the weapons for? This subject belongs to a branch of knowledge known as Akhirul Zaman, Ilm Akhirul Zaman, but in the English language it is called Islamic Eschatology. It is by far the most important branch of knowledge in your Islamic university. By far the most important branch of knowledge now to be taught in any institution of Islamic learning is Islamic eschatology, the Islamic view of Akhirul Zaman, of the last age. We have a wealth of information in the Quran and in the Ahadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. What is required is that we must be able to interpret that information and to apply it in the world in which we live today. The companions of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam were sitting talking amongst themselves when he, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, came and asked, "What are you talking about?" And they said, "We're talking about alamat as-sa'ah, the signs of the last day." And then he said, and the hadith is in Sahih Bukhari, it is in Sahih Muslim, the last day would not come until, and he mentioned 10 signs. And these are known as the 10 major signs of the last day. In addition to these 10, there are many others. Women would be dressed and yet be naked. Women would dress like men. So the night wants to become day. Men would dress like women. So your baby boys are going to grow up behaving like girls. Go ahead eating all those hormones and so on. See what's going to happen. There are many, many other signs than these 10. The 10 are, and by now you should have memorized them, for I don't have the time to test you. Number one, and these signs have not been given in the order in which they will occur. So we're giving them to you randomly. Number one, Dajjal. Al-Masih al-Dajjal. Number two, Gog and Magog. Ya'juj and Ma'juj. And incidentally, there's scarcely any proper literature on the subject written in the modern age. it is not uncharitable on my part to say, because I have attended 5 universities and I am now knocking on the door of 70 years of age, so there are some liberties I can take. It is not uncharitable for me to say that most of the literature that you find written in the modern age on these subjects is worthy of being sent on a one-way ticket to Disneyland. You know where Disneyland? Meaning it's not scholarly. It's not scholarly. So number one, Dajjal. Number two, Gog and Magog. Number three, the return of the Son of Mary. Perhaps if you turn off this fan, we might get less static here. Number three, the return of the Son of Mary. Number four, Dukhan, smoke, which I am of the opinion should be visible, I think, 20, 25 years from now. But of course, I can be mistaken. But when you see that smoke up there, you know most of mankind will not survive. There will only be few people left on the earth. Number five, Dabbatul Arq. Dabbatul Arq, a creature, a beast of the earth, or the land. Number six, that the sun will rise from the west. Number seven, eight, and nine, three, Khusuf, plural of Khas, a shaking of the earth, movement of the earth, accompanied by a sinking. So an earthquake with sinking. One in the east, one in the west, and the third one in Dr. Mansuri, UK. The third one in Arabia. And number 10, you know that the house sank down in Damansuri, UK? It was Ramadan. You know what? The whole house was down. And number 10, that the fire will come out of Yemen and drive people to their place of assembly. These are the 10. Major sign of the last day. Among these, one of the most important is Dajjal. Dajjal is a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who will one day appear in the form of a human being. I'm choosing my words very carefully. He has to appear in the form of a human being because he has been created and given a mission to impersonate the true Messiah. And since the true Messiah is a human being, the only way that Dajjal can impersonate the Messiah is if he appears as a human being. The true Messiah is the Son of Mary, Nabi Isa alayhi salam. And Allah made a promise to Banu Israel that when that Messiah comes, he would rule over from the throne of Nabi Dawood alayhi. And so the golden age of Nabi Sulaiman alayhi salam, when the state of Israel ruled over, when the state of Israel was the ruling state of the world. What's the definition of a ruling state? You must be familiar.